Casey touched the lapel pin. She was instantly stunned. What happened just now?
She squatted down again to touch the lapel pin. She traveled space in an instant. This took her directly to pick up the lapel pin. She immediately came to a field of golden wheat. There is a huge city treasure not far behind. She walked forward curiously, but something knocked her head. It seems to be a parallel world. The man just wanted to help Casey pick up the pin, but he was stopped by her. She is afraid that others will discover the secret. She wrapped the lapel pin with oil-absorbent paper. Then she let her father touch it. Her father touched it, but nothing happened. It seems that this lapel pin only works for her. Casey immediately stunned. This is so interesting. Why are you so excited? I have confiscated this lapel pin. Take advantage of her father before going to bed. Casey touched the pin on the bedside table again. She wanted to go to the city treasure, but she hit the wall. She follows the wall to find a way out. Step on empty space. Hearing and spitting noisily from the stairs. This time she pushes a bicycle, ready to illuminate on the outside. First touched the pin. Confirmed the direction of the city treasure. Then she went in that direction. After going for a while, she takes out the pin and touches again. The scene in front of her instantly brightened her eyes. At this time Casey came to an unknown parallel world. Trains suspended in the air. Rockets that return automatically. Penetrate swimming pool. Everything is so high-tech. But at this time Casey found that the pin is about to run out of battery. Casey heard a girl say they were going to a place 20 light years away. So she followed them. But the resistance under her feet is getting bigger and bigger. The pin also starts counting down. She used all her strength to get on the spaceship, but still couldn't make it. Who would have thought that this pin is still out of power? So she went home and started looking for information about the pin. She wants to find a place where this pin can be charged. Sure enough, there is a store collecting this pin. According to the address, Casey found this store. The boss just saw the pin and got excited. He asked where Casey got this pin. I don't know where it came from. Otherwise, I wouldn't have come to ask you. Casey turned around and leave after talking. Who knows, the boss and his wife raised the toy gun to keep her from leaving. Scare someone with a toy gun, but this toy gun is not simple. Tell me where the pin came from. I really don't know. At this time a steel ball broke through the window. A frozen space bomb detonates instantly. Frozen the boss and his wife. A girl broke through the window. She is here to save Casey. But Casey's hand were also frozen. The girl pulled Casey out hard. Then started fighting with the boss. Even though she's petite, her strength isn't weak. Soon the boss's head was pulled down. Turns out she is a robot. And the boss also opened the self-exposure program. Fortunately, the girl is pulling Casey. Escaped the seconds before the explosion. Then she punched at the car window. Drove away with Casey. The girl is called Athena Dot, but Casey found out that she was also a robot. She thinks these robots must all belong to the same group. A big end valve stopped the car. She gets off the car immediately. Athena just got out of the car. She was hit by a red pickup. But Casey didn't care about her. She robbed the pickup and ran away. Athena sits up. Nothing happened. Because she is a robot. Then Athena turned on sprint mode. Soon she caught up with Casey. A big jump into the bucket. Scared Casey to the brakes. Assigned her the co-pilot. Athena pulled out the key. The door handle is also broken. Casey is so scared that she screams. Athena explained. She comes from that parallel world. If she wants to return, she will have to ask for a doctor's help. Soon Casey came to the Dr. Frank's house. Go forward for a while. A black dog rushes out. Casey quickly ran away. But she found that the dog has no footprints. So she raised her hand to stroke it. It turned out to be just a holographic projection. Casey came to the door and knocked on the door. But Frank told her to get away. Then a wave of air broke her 2 miles. Frank come out and tell her. She shouldn't go to that land. But then Casey wants to go even more. Casey burned the doctor's minivan. Frank went out to deal with the fire with a small ice gun. The fire is out, but he can't go back his house. He quickly asked Casey to open the door, but she refused. Casey is putting her admiration on Frank's high technology. Frank got into the house under the stairs. The two are arguing. The alarm goes off. It turned out that there was another wave of gun-bearing robots. Frank quickly turned on the defense system. But a robot opened the iron gate one step ahead. Frank goes up to attack, causing the robot to jerk. Then Frank gave her a kick. The other one hasn't gotten to the door yet. He was also jerked by the electric current. Two robots are resting on the big iron gate. Frank presses on the keyboard. The two robots disappeared. Here comes another one behind him. Frank wants to stab the robot, but he was knocked down by the robot. Before this, Casey saw Frank's teleportation aperture. Sweep the robot in one click. Then the two squeezed into the escape bathtub. Frank opens the fan house first exposure system. The robot eye is about to peel off the bathtub cover. Frank quickly activates the button. A moment after the house explosion, the bathtub burst out with sparks and lightning. It fell into a lake not far away. Athena also drove here to pick them up. Three people passed through the space-time shuttle. Actually came to the top of the Eiffel Tower. Frank also unlocked the secret left by Thomas Edison. It is a rocket that can be teleported to a parallel world. The three quickly lifted off on a rocket. The rockets that have risen to the position begin to pick their heads and go back to work. This speed is really fast. The sky begins to twist. The trio are also dumbfounded. Soon the rocket broke through the atmosphere and came to a parallel world. The boss of the parallel world comes to welcome them. Take them into the space-time inspection tower. Here is a magical little red ball. Through it, they can see the past and future of the Earth. Casey sees the future of the Earth. Everywhere is blasts, famines, tsunamis, melting glaciers. And these will all come in 58 days. But Casey discovered all this caused by this test tower. Casey recommends closing the inspection tower. But the boss disagrees with annoyance. If he doesn't agree, then they have to take strong measures. Frank shook hands with the boss. Pressed the control button of the watch. Hurry up and blow this tower down. Then Athena took out a gas pinball from her belly. The robot detects a pinball. Catch Athena at once. The pinball was thrown to Casey. Kyuhyuha grabs the lift. But no one taught her to play this pinball. But she understood. As soon as she got to the place, she was pushed down by the boss. Fortunately, Athena uses a robot to support the elevator. Only now did Casey land safely. But the bomb before this is about to explode. Casey evacuated the bullet through the portal. The explosion of air collapsed on the pillar next to it. Push the boss underneath at once. The boss wanted to use a laser gun to kill Frank. Luckily, Athena saved Frank in time. Although Athena is a robot, but she has feelings for Frank. At this time, Athena's self-exposure system has been activated. Frank threw her to the testing doctor reluctantly. Accompanied by a loud noise, the inspection tower exploded. The boss's plan is also broken. And no one knows the future of the Earth. 1 year later, Frank restarted the recruitment plan. Use these lapel pins to recruit those who have dreams. Let's rebuild this parallel world together. If one day you also picked up such a lapel pin, will you join their dreams? I am waiting for your answer in the comment area.